I'm joined today with Stephen Hall. He's the main man behind the Stetzerizer. He's got this very interesting and useful product. And hey, Stephen, how are you today?
Yeah, I'm good.
Good. What is the Stetzerizer and what does it do?
Okay, basically the Stetzerizer is a filter that filters out dirty electricity.
Right.
Dirty electricity looks a bit like this. This is this high frequency radiation. We call transients and harmonics that ride on the electrical sine wave. Here's the 50 hertz sine wave. Our Fluke scope meter has broken up the 50 hertz from the dirty electricity component. This is the radiation that's causing a lot of sickness problems. It's causing power quality problems in the home. We're being charged for all this. This is about one third of our electricity bill. So
you're saying that our electricity bills can be reduced if we have this sort of a device plugged into them?
If you have enough of these filters. These are the filters here.
Right.
Now, we're seeing here quite a clean environment. I'm just going to walk over here and take out these filters and show you these numbers.
You've got the other filters and you're going to take them out?
Yeah, take out.
Oh, sorry,
we're unfiltered at the moment. So we're looking at... You can see that it's jumped up from over 50 something to 480 to 500.
Right,
I've turned on one of these new compact fluorescent lights that blink on and off at 300,000 times a second.
Yeah, I don't like them. They're sort of glare.
And they're even sending it up to over 600.
I forget the measurement.
This is a Stetzerizer microsurge meter.
And it's called Gauss meter. But the units of what's it called?
They're called Graham Stetzer units or GS units.
GS units. That's
GS
right.
units. Yeah, it's a measurement. They had to make up the name simply because there was no other name for this. This is basically this Fluke scope meter here.
Scope meter.
Yes, a Fluke scope meter. This is $4,000 to $6,000 meter.
Wow.
And this picks up the sine waves.
Right.
This scope meter here corresponds to this
device
called the Stetzerizer microsurge meter. And if this is showing this jagged lines and all that, it shows it's quite high radiation.
Radiation, so that's what we're talking about, coming out of our electrical appliances.
Well,
so
it's coming out of the electrical lines coming down the wall. It's above your head. It jumps onto the water pipes under the house.
If they're copper pipes and they're everywhere.
Copper pipes or even PVC, it'll still jump into the water. Jumps on the pipes and it jumps onto water as well.
So of course electricity does travel through water and it's there, of course.
It's carried on water as well. That's why there's geopathic problems in people have those disturbances in their homes.
So what are the sort of the problems that are associated with dirty electricity? I mean, health problems and other sort of problems.
Well, in our brochure here, there's a whole lot of health issues. Neurological, cardiac, respiratory, dermatological, ophthalmological,
burning eyes,
and others. For example, pain in the teeth, impaired sense of smell, digestive problems, immune disorders, deteriorating vision, cataracts, skin rash, burning. You'll see when people use these lights, the compact fluorides, they're getting a lot of rashes on their skin, and they're getting confusion in their mind.
Is it true that these have been made the only legal light? Are we being forbidden to buy? That's not even compact.
No, this is a new type. This is called an LED.
Okay.
This is a clean LED. There are dirty LEDs, but this is creating a clean light. Nice cool light. You can actually hold onto it.
So it doesn't generate heat.
Yeah. So this is the old incandescent.
That's quite hot.
You can't grab that light. It's so hot. This doesn't create dirty electricity.
No, they don't.
And this doesn't either.
But the new mercury-filled, what are they called?
Compact fluoros. So they're CFLs, compact fluoro lights.
And that's what we've been mandated as our only legal light bulb.
Yeah, we have to install these now.
Sorry.
But there's a new technology coming out. This is the LED. They're very, very expensive at the moment because they're only new on the market.
It'd be nice if you could dim that because, it's got six sort of... things inside it, which you can't see.
This is only about 13 to 15 watts, producing about 60 watts of light.
Yeah.
So they're low energy.
Right.
And
so these devices, they're on sale here for how much? 100 and something, 160?
Right. What we recommend is that people buy a pack of 15 filters and one microsurge meter, mm-hmm. and they're on sale for $975. Normally about $1,075.
You buy their individual pieces?
Yeah. Right. Yeah, you have to buy them individually, it's quite expensive.
Yep.
And you need, the average house needs about 15 filters.
Yep. So that's to neutralize all the ambient or transient noise on the...
Yeah, the electrical noise on the wiring.
Right.
So it actually smooths out the dirty electrical noise or the dirty electricity, EMI.
It'd be nice if... we could get clean electricity straight from the source, you know.
Yes, but what's going to happen?
They're giving us this dirty electricity. So I guess they're giving us dirty water as well with the chemicals and
fluoride and the heavy chlorine. Salts and chlorine. Exactly.
So really,
we've got to clean up our water at home with a filtered system. We need to clean up our electricity.
Yeah.
And it's unfortunate because we've got a 1920s grid.
Yeah.
Electrical grid. Then they're putting on. We've got 2010 technology.
All the laptops electricals.
They're going from AC, that's pulsed 240 volt current, to DC 12 volt, and it's causing. It's taking bites out of the sine wave and creating dirty electricity.
Right.
So it backs it up and puts it back onto the sine wave as dirty electricity. So it takes it out of the smooth sine wave and puts it back as dirty electricity and spiking it up into high frequency currents. But the filters are filtering all that out, pushing it back out of the meter box.
The woman I heard speak yesterday spoke about
Donna Fisher,
the Silent Fields author, that actually cancer clusters are good indicators of dirty electricity.
Yes, they are.
You can see in offices where people are sitting at their computers all day, and when you take the meter to those offices, which wasn't done in the official inquiry or investigation, you can see the high level of dirty electricity, and it directly correlates with breast cancer and prostate cancer.
And many other cancers. And myself, I'm in Donna's book called More Silent Fields.
Right.
And in that book, I talk about my journey with multiple sclerosis, which is an autoimmune disease.
Right.
And I'd spoken to Dave Stetzer about this, and I'd put the filters in about 12 months earlier. Mm-hmm. And he said, Steve, in around 12 months of having your house filtered, you'll probably go into remission. Right. Exactly 12 months later, I had another MRI scan, and it showed a whole diminishing of the demyelinating plaques on my brain, and the size of the prominence. So I'm officially in remission.
Remission from MS.
MS simply because I've
filtered out dirty electricity. I didn't know that happened. Really.
Yeah. Well, I'm electrically sensitive. My type of multiple sclerosis, which is remitting relapsing, is definitely related to dirty electricity.
Right.
So you clean up the electricity, your immune system begins to recover, and whatever you take, you know, vitamins and minerals and all the necessary things are not compromised anymore, so you actually are getting the benefit of the vitamins.
I heard another one as well, vitamin A and sunlight for MS sufferers. That's another...
Vitamin D?
Vitamin D, that's right, sunlight.
Vitamin D, Vitamin A is in carrot juice, and too much of it can damage... damaging, but vitamin D, which is sunlight, and in sunlight, is very important.
Great, and Stetzerizers, I'm going to get myself one of them, because I know that behind my bedhead, there's a copper wire that I can hear a hum at night, and I wake up with headaches most mornings.
Wow. Yeah. Well, we're about to reduce, so it's 453, 490. We're about to reduce that now by turning on one filter. It's brought it down to 80 to 90. Put on another filter, let's drop it now to 60, and then we're going to put on two more filters.
We should re-plug those ones in.
There we are.
Plugged it in, one, two.
So that's brought it down to 40s, 30s to 40s. Right,
and it was at previously 500 and something.
Yeah, which is a cancer cluster has been recognised at 460 or 480 GS units. So when it's 400 and plus, it can be a cancer cluster in the place.
Goodness.
This is one of the only instruments in the world that can determine what where a cancer cluster may be.
And this is from Stetsarizer as well, this EMF, or what is it, what microsurge meter, is that what you
mean? Yeah, that's right. It's basically showing the dirty power, the dirty electricity that's on the electrical wiring, which is now clean. So where I'm sitting now, it's a totally clean environment. I'm very happy, and I'm glad I'm not anywhere else.
And it might affect the people right next to you. So in your office, for instance, you have one, and your office benefits from it.
Yeah, well, of course, it's atmospheric. Okay. So you know, if you're in a clean electrical environment, and you're near someone with filters, you're going to feel the benefit of that.
Right.
But if you're more than 2 meters away, or 2 to 3 meters away, you'll start to, the dirty electricity will start to build up there.
Great. Thanks very much for your time.
That's a pleasure. Thanks.